In the Vedomo virtual classroom, people have an audio and video connection and can easily communicate with each other. By default settings, the host of the session is in an individual video and participants are in a video mosaic. These video windows can be moved, resized, or hidden if you want to focus the attention of the content on the whiteboard. Audio and video files can be played in the integrated media player for all participants to listen and watch simultaneously. You may upload them from your device or just copy and paste the link from YouTube. The whiteboard can be used to share various types of materials with participants. First, you need to upload them into the file library. They can be documents, presentations, images, and many others. Once uploaded, they can be placed on separate pages of the whiteboard. The whiteboard tools allow you to work collaboratively with all participants. With the text tool, you can type on the whiteboard. Use the brush for handwriting, drawing, or underlining. You can share shapes and figures on the whiteboard. Put a grid on the whiteboard if you need to draw geometrical figures. You can have two or more participants working simultaneously. When you click on an object or text, you can see who has created it. Click on the three dots in the down left corner to open the whiteboard settings. You can choose to allow participants to browse the whiteboard pages. In this way, you can have them work individually on their own page. You can even write your participants' names instead of the page's numbers. Switch to a simple view only mode if you work with young kids and you don't want them to get distracted by the whiteboard tools on the left and the buttons on the right side. Screen sharing is a useful tool to show any files, programs, applications, or web pages that cannot be imported on the whiteboard. During the online session, both the host and all participants can share their screens. From the Groups menu, you can create breakout rooms. This option allows you to divide participants in separate groups and send them to separate rooms. In this way, communication between groups is not possible. It is useful for splitting larger groups of participants into smaller ones or pairs for discussions or completing assignments or even for individual tasks. To save time when preparing for a session, you don't need to upload your files one by one before each session. You may use session templates and reuse them with a different group of participants. You just need to upload and arrange your files on the whiteboard pages. Then click on the three dots at the bottom of the screen and choose Session Templates. When saved as a template, it takes only a few seconds for your materials to be loaded into the virtual classroom and you can start your session. The Participants button in the down right corner of the virtual classroom opens an additional menu where the host can switch off and on participants' microphones and cameras. There is also a settings icon which leads to a control panel. Here, the host can adjust the level of participants' microphones and mute and unmute them, have a participant in an individual video or in the video mosaic. The host can also allow or deny the participants the access to certain functionalities. For example, to give permission or forbid the participants to write on the whiteboard or edit objects, to show or hide the chat in the virtual classroom. To have personal chats. This can be done at an individual level for a specific participant and at a group level for all participants at once. After the session is finished and you want to save your collaborative work with all the annotations you have done together with your participants, you can export the content of the whiteboard to a PDF format from here. You may find more detailed explanations about all the tools and features in our Virtual Classroom Tutorials playlist on YouTube.